Welcome back, this is RB. If you like this video at any point, be sure to like and comment. It's the only way we'll grow. Now let's get into this ridiculous nonsense. Matter of fact, before we get into this video, fellas, let me know how many red flags you count just now before I even hit the play button. And let's see if our numbers match up.
Like a guy, no eye contact, body language away, and I just pretend like they don't exist, because then there's no chance for rejection. So I'm like,
it comes from feeling unsure of yourself and being afraid of getting hurt.
But then if I don't like someone, this is how I am. Oh yeah, wow, tell me more. You don't
That's stupid.
It dang bads. Don't be mad at them. Just realize how they're fucking dingbats.
I think they're becoming stupider, to be honest.
The first thing I want to say, fellas, this is what you should do. If you like a chick, totally ignore her. That's the best way to get her attention. Because she used to everybody kissing her butt and telling her how great she is. She used to beta male orbiters, you know, asking is there anything they can do for her and all that. Completely ignore and pretend like she doesn't exist. And she'll be coming up asking you questions. Not all the time. I mean, you still have to be attractive, of course. But honestly, even if you're not attractive, she's still going to wonder, like, what's up with this dude? Now, on to her, she basically admitted that she's scared of rejection. She's been rejected her whole life. By what type of guy? You know what type of guy. Those guys have been putting her through trauma year after year after year. So now she thinks if she acts like she doesn't like those guys, that'll get her better results.
It's not going to happen.
She basically saying she flirt with the guys she don't like, which is really messed up because she's going to get a lot of those guys to think that she's genuinely interested. And then she's going to break their heart and play games with them and all that. So this is completely wrong. And stuff like this is the reason why most women just aren't good people. Because many of them are willing to destroy lives and play with people's emotions, break hearts, just because she was bored. Or just because she got in her feelings about something. With no remorse. She couldn't give a damn if any of these guys she playing with jump off the Empire State Building. Long as she able to get her Starbucks the next morning. And get her latest cringe tattoo this weekend.
Who hurt you?
I mean, this isn't a bad looking woman. I mean, this is another potential wife and mother gone to waste. She could have been a loving, wholesome mother and wife. Instead, she took the tatted up, ran through by Chad route, crying out for help on the internet.
That's a damn shame.
All I want is to do share love and feel with people. And it's like, no, you don't get any of that, you dirty whore.
I'm going to teach you how to be a proper gym slut, okay? It took me months to figure out how girls got their shorts like slurped up in their booty cheeks. Like, babe, that's slurped up in there all the way. Also, I had stains, so I took like a Tide pen. That's why there's little wet spots.
Okay.
So when you first put on your shorts, they're probably gonna look something like this. Like, it is not given body yaddy yaddy. So what you're gonna do, and there's probably a better way.
Before she even tell us the tricks and the secrets, look, it's all a facade. Their whole lives is based on a facade. How can I make my booty look bigger even though it isn't big? How can I make my boobs look bigger even though they aren't big? How can I make my face look pretty when it isn't pretty? Their whole life is a lie. But they always talking about they can't stand a guy who's a liar. Cut the fucking shit. I swear the tattoos red flag never fails to the point where, look man, do not take a woman serious if she has one tattoo.
What I do, I just shove them up in there. I don't fold them. I don't got time for that. And I just quite literally don't give that much of a f-. Now, most important part, what you're going to do is you're quite literally just, there's no good way of saying this. You shove it up your asshole. You shove it so far up your asshole.
That's nasty.
Why are you always such a nasty bitch?
You're a whore.
Women who tend to be nasty.
Like I said, of course she's a vile piece of I don't know if I've ever interacted with a woman who was tatted up, who wasn't a potty mouth, you know, trash character having broad. At least she's keeping it real about her intentions, about, look, I'm going to the gym to be an absolute SLU, you know what. I'm wearing this outfit so I can get attention from all the hot, buff dudes. But always keep in mind, she's still only looking for the top 20% of hot, buff dudes to give her attention and plower. Never forget that aspect of things.
Trigger warning. Sorry to all my babes with hemorrhoids. You're really not gonna like this one.
What?
Weird, buddy. You're weird.
It was a pleasure. It really wasn't. You're weird. I don't like you, and I'm all set. Thanks for nothing. Goodbye.
This is what people don't see about co-parenting with a person that takes away everything from you. He took away my happiness. He took away all the material things. He took away the happiness of my oldest child. Mm-hmm. And when you come to the police with your papers from the court showing them that the other co-parent is violating that court order, that that person harassed you, that that person makes false accusations to CPS, that that person is making your life a living hell.
It was self-inflicted pain, so it was my own fault that I was crying every single day.
I need to use my shirt because I don't have a tissue. Tissue, please.
I don't know if those accusations are false. The pink hair, the fact that you're on the internet crying and having a breakdown, you don't seem mentally stable. So I'm going to go with those accusations were true. I don't know. Don't sue me. I'm just speculating. You knew who he was the first 2 weeks you met him. I don't want to hear it. You signed up for this knowing damn well what type of character this man had. Or the fact that he lacked character. You knew it.
Sly son of a bitch.
They want all the benefits of being with a bad boy with none of the cons, and that just doesn't make sense.
Where has common sense gone, guys? Where has self-respect gone?
But yeah, I don't think this video is going to help any case that you got ongoing.
There's never no one behind the person suffering this. This man has taken away everything from me just because I can't pay for a lawyer. For a modification case, a lawyer asked here in Texas up to $15,000 just a deposit.
Damn.
Never there's anyone to help mom or dad. They're passing and trying to co-parent with another co-parent. This is our Bible, but we are the only ones following it. Police is not there to help you.
I wonder, is there a Cash App link in her bio? I wonder, is that how this video is going to end? So please donate to my cause.
The court is not there to help you. There's never nobody. There's no lawyers there to help you.
Right.
Because as long as the child sleeps at your house, you're well served. You're fine. You won the case. A case that has haunted me for 4 years in a domestic abuse relationship with this man.
How often did you beat his ass?
They will kick those heels off and beat your butt.
And he's still haunting me 4 years after because I...
So when did the DV start? Did it start before you had his offspring? After? They always want you to believe that these guys are just sweet, loving, wholesome men for the first couple of years, and then all of a sudden they turn into monsters.
It's unbelievable.
Don't stop being a court. This man, for every single thing that doesn't go his way, takes me to court. Now he has our child.
You know, usually guys who are really horrible guys don't even take women to court. They don't even put this much effort in.
Oh my gosh, I've never heard about that.
The fact that this guy's taking time out of his life to take you to court, he's probably a decent dude. They only tell one side of the story. The man's the demon and she's the angel. Never believe a story from a woman where she never does anything wrong in the story. Just automatically know it's BS.
That is bullshit.
For his summer vacation, and after agreeing on text message to give me the weekend of the...
Say that about a woman. Why can't you say women are wrong when they're wrong?
You want to be making moves on the street, have no attachments, allow nothing to be in your life that you cannot
walk out on in 30 seconds flat.
Okay, first of all, I didn't miss the red flags. I looked at them and thought, damn, that's sexy. And that's my problem.